This next example will show how to build a custom piece of equipment. Navigate to the Equipment ribbon menu. Under the User-Defined group, select the Solids command, and that will enable the general microstation solids. These can be used to build a custom piece of equipment as simplistic or detailed as needed. In this example, a simple tower containing multiple solid components will be created. Start by using a solid slab and define the length, width, and height. Input the following various dimensions: 6500, 3000, and 2250 millimeters. Use the AccuDraw features to rotate and place the solid slab. Take note of the AccuDraw compass that appears. Toggle through the different axes. Press the F key to rotate to a front plane axis. Press the T key to rotate to a top plane axis. Press the S key to rotate to a side plane axis. Choose the left mouse click and the system prompts for the direction of the solid slab. Drag the cursor to the left or to the west. Lastly, input the height and direction. Those inputs can be changed dynamically, and it will lock the solids at those predetermined values. Left-click to accept the values and repeat the steps again. Place another solid on top of the existing slab. Define the length, the width, and the height values. The solid slab can be modified after placement. In this example, chamfer the edges. Select the chamfer command from the ribbon menu. Change the method to distance and angle. Input a distance and an angle. Left-click on each edge that needs chamfered. Repeat the steps for the sides. Model one more solid component to complete this piece of equipment. In this example, do not define the values. Use the AccuDraw and AccuSnap features to define the length, the width, and the height. Once the various objects are modeled that are part of this custom piece of equipment, there is one more step that should be taken on any 3D solids or objects that have been modified. In this example, the solids have been chamfered. They must be converted into a smart solid by highlighting the component and selecting the Convert to Solid button, then choosing the smart solid. The object is now converted to a smart solid and is ready to be created as a custom piece of equipment. Use the Control key to highlight and select the various objects to create the custom equipment from. Use the overlap feature by left-clicking, holding, and dragging over the components. Be careful not to include the components underneath. In this example, highlight the three components. Switch back to the OpenPlant modeler workflow. Navigate to the Equipment ribbon menu in order to create the equipment by selecting the Create Equipment icon. Choose the class or category of equipment to assign to. In this example, choose the generic piece of equipment, then click the Create button. A dialog will appear whenever any out-of-the-box piece of equipment is placed. Associations, including the tag and properties, can be defined. Name this CE for custom equipment. Define other component properties if needed. Choose the Apply Changes button and close the dialog. Hovering over the component displays that this is now a piece of OpenPlant equipment. Select the Element Selection tool. Right-click and choose the Modify Component command and change any properties needed. Out-of-the-box equipment components are parametric. This means dimensional properties, like on this particular pump, can be dynamically changed. Because these were out-of-the-box OpenPlant pieces of equipment, those properties can be changed afterwards. A custom piece of equipment like this one has some special steps that need to be taken to be able to modify that equipment. To modify this equipment, right-click and hold on it. Then choose the drop command. This enables the capability to be able to grab any of these components and modify them as needed. Select any of these handles, for example, and choose the modification that is needed. In this example, this solid needs to be extended, then extend that tower 500 mm up. The solids now need regenerated to update this as a piece of equipment. Although it's been dropped, these steps can be followed to recreate it into the custom equipment. This shape or box is holding the intelligence from the first time it was created. Select these components again. Go back into the Create Equipment dialog. Change the class again. At this point, only choose the Update Existing button. Be careful when selecting these components. Do not include the box. Only select the components that are part of the custom piece of equipment. The box only contains the intelligence. Choose the Update Existing button. The software will prompt to select the existing component. Select the box to grab the intelligence. Left-click on that box, then left-click again to accept it. The command line will now say Create Custom Component is done. This equipment has now been dropped, modified, and then recreated using Update Existing, and is now back to the original tagged custom piece of equipment.